Outbreak in the Oval Office. Welcome to Extra. I'm Billy Bush. Unbelievable how poetic. The only thing to spread faster than the virus itself, Twitter's reaction to President Trump's diagnosis. Today, from cracks about karma to some celebrity support, Hollywood is chirping. The president and first lady in quarantine. The headline writers typing feverishly. The nation got its first clue there was trouble when the president called into Sean Hannity on Fox News Channel last night. Just 2 hours later, it was confirmed they do.
You could tell from the way he was speaking that he was really freaked out by it. He must have had a preliminary indication that this was going to be positive.
Jonathan Karl, ABC News chief White House correspondent and author of Front Row at the Trump Show, talked with me today. What do you imagine happens to the debates?
I'm told the vice presidential debate next week is likely to go forward, but the presidential debates are completely in doubt, less likely to happen than happen.
I think something's happening here. This is the greatest showman on earth.
It's the ultimate cliffhanger. The question is it the season finale or is it the series finale? Even the people that can't stand him don't wish his health ill. But this is serious business.
The contact tracing, there's a lot more names to come, don't you think?
I mean, this contact tracing is a who's who of Washington.
Ivanka, her husband Jared, and first son Barron have all tested negative. So did former VP Joe Biden. Hollywood was quick to react to the health news online. Harsh critic Bette Midler put forth her own conspiracy theory, tweeting, "I guess Trump's quarantining will mean no rallies and no more debates. Convenient." Jimmy Kimmel, does anyone know why Mike Pence is running around in circles throwing little pieces of Wonder Bread in the air? Ice-T, can I say karma's a B-word? You know what he meant. But two of Mr. Trump's biggest critics came to his defense. MSNBC's Rachel Maddow tweeted, "If you pray, please pray for their speedy and complete recovery." Alyssa Milano, who still has post-COVID symptoms herself, said, not too conspicuously, "I wouldn't wish this virus on my worst enemy." President Trump with COVID-19 is just one more issue that both sides are going to want to win. So the political implications, we'll leave that for others. But right now, our InstaMD, Dr. Dorian, is here. 74 years old, many would say obese, maybe not morbidly obese, but doesn't that put him in a high-risk category?
There's no question. It was proven that obesity is a significant risk factor with COVID-19. And this is not being derogatory saying obese. This is a scientific data number, and our president falls into that category.
They say mild symptoms for him. Would you say his prognosis is good?
For most who get the illness, you do well. So we're talking probably over 90%. He's gonna do well. But here's the issue. This, with the risk factors and with mild symptoms, says we don't know. We're on a course. The next 5 to 7 days is really gonna start giving us a direction of how his body specifically will deal with this virus.
The diagnosis came just after another controversy erupted around the First Lady. CNN played audio of Melania, secretly recorded by her former senior advisor in 2018, expressing frustration about criticism for the president's family separation policy. We are updating any new developments all weekend at extratv.com. Thank you for watching. If you want more Extra, hit the subscribe button and the bell so you'll never miss a video.